Behavioral data comes in under that.
Or even behavioral
yes.
data.
So whatever data that you are storing about a customer is under its purview. Now, I think what GDPR will, see, any industry goes through evolution, right? And whenever a regulator comes in, you have to realize that it is evolving and it is maturing. Otherwise, you know, it's kind of, it's in its growth stage and, you know, nobody bothers about it. So GDPR, what it is going to do, it is going to give back the control of personal data back to the user.
Correct.
So it's a very welcome move. What it is going to do is also ensure that any provider will have to respect that. So I think all of us in the room who are sitting there will have to be GDPR compliant sooner or later.
I agree with you.
Yes.
But so in probably amongst all of you, probably I'm the only business whose business is to sell data
sure.
at its very raw.
Sure.
If I were to put my business model in a very, very raw form, it's
sure.
this. And one of the largest challenges we face, although there are very strict laws about do not DNDs on messages,
right.
email, abusing email IDs, you'd be surprised to know that every year, a lot of universities get very easy access to the entire IIT
right.
database,
That's right.
So for so much for privacy, right?
Sure, sure.
So there, and it's not just, and I remember a very key instance wherein there were newspaper articles about this, and that guy who sells the database was very brazenly still selling the day. So I feel there is a very these are all ideal case scenarios wherein we are talking about that we will, and probably as companies become larger, if you are the Googles of the world, but I don't think the enforcement of these laws in India
right.
are as strong so as to affect anything at all. I don't even feel it will move the needle, as it has not been happening for the last so many years. I know for sure, and there are so many points in wherein data leaks happen, right? And unless there are examples set wherein once a data leak has happened and companies are prosecuted or they are sued and they have to pay fines to the tunes of millions of dollars.
So, Upneet, what you're saying is absolutely correct. And
right.
there's a reality fact
right.
check and you know, there's no doubt about that. What we are saying is, see, in any unregulated market, this is now being a regulated market. There's a data, right?
Right.
Because there's so much of data footprint that a digital customer leaves behind, this was bound to happen.
Yeah.
What we are saying is that the providers will have to be compliant.
Right.
What it means is, theoretically, when you install an Android app, you're giving permissions, right?
Yeah.
Do you bother to even read those? Nobody is reading anything. In fact, when you give permission to read SMS, we don't realize that for companies who are having an app, you can read SMS. That means you can read all about my transactions,
right?
Right? So the kind of information then I have about you is mind-boggling.
Yeah.
So, but people still give.
Right.
What I'm saying is that this is going to be a regulated industry. We will have to be compliant. We will ask for permission. Customers are going to give permission. Will that still make those customers so, you know, aware, and they will minutely manage their permissions and all, is a different matter. Will there be mechanisms to share data, sell data legally, etc.? All of that will be there, but it will be much regular. So it's like GST. Once it comes into effect, it's very difficult for any trader to stay out of it, because then the network effects, come in. Yeah. And so the point is, we will have to be compliant at some stage, and then it will evolve as a market for everybody, for data exchange and everything.
I want to go back to Gaurav's point.
Yeah.
Actually, the government is giving a lot of scholarships, and even one of the points which I want to share, as a university, as a faculty, that are very less bandwidth, specifically with the universities, to create content specifically for the students. And there is a new program we were looking for that is called SWAM by the government initiative,
yeah.
where the government is giving a huge funding. And even there is an institution called NUPA, where one of the senior professors, we basically called him for our faculty development in ICT specifically. And he's ready to pay us 20 lakh rupees to basically develop the content. But we don't have a bandwidth inside our department. We are basically trying to work out how to basically do, however, we are having a media school also. We are having a studio also, you know, but as far as now I am saying, just one university is ready to pay. It means government is having huge funding, because you see Coursera and Edtech, they are basically selling large number of courses across India, and even we as a professors, we are basically learning new things, and there are a large number of students also. If we can basically work out, you to all companies and EdTech basically work out and take a lead in this particular area. They can pitch into the these 900 universities. There are the twin benefits. One, the government is basically funding it. You can develop the content, and then you can get a pool of best professors and lectures are coming up, which you can basically work out as the brand building exercise, and those best professors can be marketed internationally also. So India's brand building can work out in this particular way. So that is the one area where we can work out this particular direction, and automatically there are very good professors across India. They may be in one university teaching to one. You know, we all remember our best professor of our time. You know, it's somewhere in our subconscious mind who is the best professor. Sometimes with this particular initiative, we can come out with the best professors and we can sell our courses across the world. But that initiative can EdTech can basically take on and further move on.
Okay, so before I just wrap it up, is there anything you want to sum up?
So I think a quick sum up. We have had a great discussion. So the sum up that we are talking about is, we're talking about EduTech, but I think we are still very cognizant of the limitations, what it enables and what it doesn't. I think that's a great healthy discussion that we had today. Other thing is about the importance of data. We also talked about where, out of the recommendations, still they have to be very relevant and very targeted. It cannot be the same as e-commerce. We talked about personas and, the domain understanding has to be different for different providers. We talked about social side of EduTech as well. So I think overall a great discussion, some great points that came out of our discussion today. I'm sure that all of us really enjoyed being part of it.
Yeah, just to add to that, I think there's no going away from the fact that we're sitting at the cusp of a huge change, and change that that takes machine learning and regular basic common sense, and kind of brings the two together. That blend is not going to go away. And as we go ahead, I'm just hoping that this group kind of sticks to it and keeps the discussion going, because we've created, a forum at least, for us to start exchanging platforms.
On that point, here's a question. Is everybody is open to it? What if we create a WhatsApp group and?
Absolutely, I think that's.
Engaging with each other.
I think everybody will benefit from it. It's we should do it. I'll get Latika to create this and do it. So thank you for taking the effort. Thank you for taking the trouble. I know that you guys have traveled a long distance. As Upneet is going to hate me because he thinks. But thank you once again. And let's continue this offline.